All right. We're talking about multiplying and dividing by powers of 10. Okay, now let's remind ourselves what powers of 10 are. Powers of 10 would be like 10 to the second, 10 to the third, 10 to the fourth, 10 to the zero. Okay, one that they'll introduce today that's different than what you've had in the past, 10 to the negative first, 10 to the negative second, 10 to the negative third. Okay, those are all powers of 10. Okay, understand that these powers of 10, like that's equal to 100, that's equal to 1,000, that's equal to 10,000. Now, here's the one that's a little different, 10 to the zero power. 10 to the zero power is 1. Okay, every single time, it's 1. Anything raised to the first zero power is 1. So 5 to the 0 power is 1, 6 to the 0 power is 1. Anytime you raise a number to the power of 0, it's always 1. Now, 10 to the negative first is like 1 over 10. 10 to the negative second is 1 over 100. 10 to the negative third is 1 over 1,000. Okay? So, the desk or in the air handler room.
I know. Well, we know that. We have a key for it.
Miss Angela has a key for it.
Okay.
Now, before we were rudely interrupted, all right, Jacob, shut the door. They were born in a barn, so they don't know how to do that. All right. So, if I have 34... times 10 to the second power. Okay? Most of the time, you would take 34, 10 to the second power is 100, so I multiply it times. You don't have to do all that. There's a very simple shortcut that you can follow to do the problem. The shortcut is this. You look at the 2. Okay? We're going to come down here, and we're going to write the number 34. Where would the decimal be in the number 34, the whole number 34? Nick, where would it be? Since it's not up there, where is it?
Behind the
4. Okay, so your decimal is right here. All we're going to do is we're going to take that decimal and we're going to move it once, twice. Whoops, wrong way. I did division a while ago, so I'm thinking division, not multiplication. Once, twice, to the right. We're going to move it 2 places to the right. Okay, so now my decimal is right here. Well, I have to fill in those 2 spots with zeros, making my number 3,400. Okay, now, here is the problem that most of sixth grade has. We are not just adding 2 zeros. Okay, and I will show you why we're not just adding 2 zeros. You are moving the decimal to the right, the number of places of the exponent. So, for example, if that was 34 times 10 to the third power, then we would take 34, the decimal being right there, and we would move that decimal once, twice, 3 times. And that would add zeros. Okay, and so there would be 34... 1,000. Lily?
Can we put the decimal in our answer?
No, you don't have a decimal in your answer unless there's numbers behind the decimal. You don't, in other words, do not, don't just put a decimal right there. Don't do that. Okay? Just 3,400. This one's 34,000. Brittany?
What about if it's negative?
I'm going to cover that. Okay? So, our rule then is this. When multiplying, yeah, didn't leave enough room. A number